Even Jung has said that you have to go beyond your thoughts, and that you have to become thoughtlessly aware. Even in our shastras is written that you have to have nirvichar samadhi, means without thought, and then another is nirvikalpa samadhi. Now even Einstein has said that you have to go beyond the mind to reach the torsion area, he thinks. When he was searching for his theory of relativity, he found it was difficult. He couldn't find it. He got very tired. He went into his garden and was playing with soap bubbles like a child. Then he says, suddenly from somewhere else, it dawned upon me this theory of relativity. He calls it openly as a torsion area. And this torsion area we have to touch instead of ourselves thinking all the time and reacting. Because as a result of that, what happens, we should see. What happens is that our movement on the autonomous nervous system goes to the right side. The right side is very good, otherwise a person looks very impressive, he can oppress others, he can be aggressive, he can be very systematic, all these things can be there. But it has a reaction. The reaction is horrible because this right side affects our liver to begin with. Now the liver is called liver because we live because of liver only. That's why it's called liver. This liver gets affected and there is no actually treatment, we should say, in the medical science for liver. They can replace it with a pig's liver or some liver like that. But otherwise, there is no way out. But we are the ones, we are spoiling this liver ourselves by creating tremendous heat in the liver. This special liver has got a capacity to absorb heat and release it into the bloodstream. And then, you see, it gets relieved of it. But when it is too much, when the liver is too much, full of heat, then it cannot give up that heat. Then this heat starts traveling upward. It can go to the right lung. It can go to the heart. Now imagine right lung means asthma. Simple thing is asthma. Then it goes to the heart. When there's a young boy, say of 21 years or so, up to that age, he starts playing cricket, tennis, and drinks a lot. Then he gets a massive heart attack. It's fatal, he cannot live. Then it affects, as I told you, other organs also. This heat goes to the pancreas, causing diabetes of a very serious nature, not of a mild nature, but a very serious nature. Then this heat passes down to the spleen. In the spleen, it gives you blood cancer. This is all possible for all right-sided people, I'm telling you. That's why I was worried that people who are, according to me, are the spine of our country. They are the spine of our country. They should not get out of life because of too much of strain and stress on their mind. Now then it goes to the kidneys. It coagulates the kidneys, and you get kidney trouble, or you cannot pass urine, and you have all the troubles there. Apart from that, it goes to the lower intestines, and you get terrible constipations and all the problems of the constipation. Then, also to the heart. At a later age, it comes. It goes on affecting, ultimately, your heart fails. Very early in age, I know of Recently, two people died of heart trouble who were at a very good position. This is very much worrying me, that how to bring them to close to themselves, to know themselves, what the problem is, and how to solve that problem. With this we understand that we react, by reaction we create such a heat within us. Apart from this, the other psychosomatic diseases, I'm telling about somatic, but the psycho disease which comes from your psychological problems comes from the left side. Of course, I'll not deal with that now. But somehow, if you can move from right to the left, you are sure to get some psychosomatic trouble which cannot be cured by medical science, like cancer, AIDS, all kinds of things. So you are just preparing your body for them. In these modern times, the life is so full of struggle, speed. Now we were coming and there was a jam. Now you can't help it. I was very silently watching. Now this is the jam. I have to reach late, doesn't matter. My husband normally would have been really in great trouble. He would have looked at the watch all the time, would have been, wow, where are we? What are we doing? This and that. But he was so silently watching the whole thing, I was amazed. Because normally he would be jittery that we are getting so late for a function like. Now, you see, once you get rid of this problem, it's the easiest thing to live. The other day I met one gentleman who was transferred. He said, always whenever, he is an IAS officer, whenever I am transferred, mother, I used to be so jittery, such tension, such stress on my mind, Baba, what will happen, where will the children go, what will happen to the house, this, that, all problems would come to me. But what has happened to me and my wife, we don't feel anything now. We don't feel. We are not worried. We sleep very well. I said, that's what has to happen. All these things should not affect you. That's only possible when you can go beyond this mind which